The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1903. Move paid records to another worksheet. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill John. Well, today's question, we have this data here on the original sheet, and when something gets marked as paid, so we change from N to Y, we want to move that data automatically over to the data sheet. I'm presuming just to the next blank row. And I'm going to do this with VBA. You might be able to write an array formula that would extract all of the Y values to that other sheet. But I'm going to do it with VBA. And I notice that my data, my workbook is stored as xlsx. That's the one type of file that is not allowed to have macros. So I'm going to have to do file save as. And when I go to save this, we'll change the type to xlsm or xlsb, any of them, just not xlsx. And we'll save it there. All right, so now we're allowed to have macros. If you've never used macros before, we want to do Alt T M S and make sure that the we're not set to that highest setting, which is the default. You want to come down to disable all macros with notification. All right, and I'm currently here on the original sheet. We're looking for paid in column G, which is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th column. So I'm going to press Alt F11. And in the Project Explorer, if you can't see the Project Explorer, go to View, Project Explorer, or Control R. We're going to look for our workbook. There's 1903. Might be collapsed. You might need to expand it. Find the original sheet and double-click. All right, now, from here, we're going to choose from the top left drop-down, choose Worksheet. They automatically assume we want selection change, which is not right. We'll change that to change, so we can get rid of this tiny macro here. So this is a little macro that's going to run every time that we change any cell on the worksheet. So the first thing we have to do, we have to figure out what we just changed. The variable target holds what we just changed. So if target.column is equal to 7. Now in my case, it's 7 because that is the 7th column. If your data is somewhere else, then you need to use whichever column number it is. Then if target dot value is equal to yes, and let's see, do we want to allow them to type lowercase yes, or it does have to be uppercase yes? I guess if we want to do either, we would say if the lowercase of what they just typed is equal to a lowercase yes. That way, if they put either a lowercase y or an uppercase y, then we're good to go. Then we want to move this record. End if. So that's the start of our macro there. Now, the move this record part. We need to figure out where to go. All right, so the first thing we have to figure out is where's the next available record on the data worksheet? And I'm going to switch back to Excel here and go look at the data worksheet. And we have to choose a column that's going to be filled in all the time. Now, like in this case, region is perfect. That's always filled in. But you might have a column that has salutation or apartment number that's not always filled in. And if that was in column A, we'd want to move from column 1 over to column 2. So back to VBA. NR is my variable for to hold next record is equal to worksheets data.cells. Let's go rows.count, comma 1. Press the N key, XL up, that's the letter L there, dot row plus 1. All right, so that's going to find the last row in the data worksheet that has data and add 1 to it. And then from row is going to be equal to target dot row. And then we're just going to do a copy. So from the worksheet's original, dot cells, the from row, comma 1, column 1, dot resize, one row, and then we have to figure out how many columns we have, and I'll go back and look here. So 7 columns. If your data went out past column G, you might have more columns. You have to get the right number of columns there. 7 dot copy, and I'm going to put a continuation character, the underscore, space underscore is a continuation character, and the destination colon equals is worksheets data dot cells next row comma 1. All right, so missed a closing paren there. All right, that should be it. So just those short little lines of code put back here on the worksheet code pane. Let's just give it a try here. So we'll choose AT&T. This is the 2401. I'll change that from N to Y. I'll press Enter. See, it didn't look like anything happened. You actually might have seen the cursor change to the spinning blue wait symbol for just less than a second. When we come back here to the data tab, that record has been added to the correct place. Back here, we choose another record. Yes, enter. It doesn't look like anything happened, but the data is automatically being added back there to the data worksheet. Short little macro. I know a lot of people have never used macros before, but this should not be that intimidating. Just a few lines of code that will solve this problem. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast.
Mr. Excel.